it's going to be costly for businesses. There's no way that it can't be.
It's a common concern among small business owners, the ability to provide affordable health insurance for their employees.
How was lunch today?
John Bogues, the owner of the Mark Twain Dinette in Hannibal, he experienced the cost associated with a company health insurance policy. About 10 years ago, he provided a group insurance option for staff at an affordable rate.
Within 2 years, the rate had more than tripled, and was such a drain on the profitability of the restaurant, we were just unable to continue it and had to stop.
In recent years, similar experiences among small businesses have led to a growth of misinformation with the Affordable Care Act. For instance, small business owners thought they would be required to provide coverage, but in fact, only big businesses will have to pay up.
So if you have less than 50 employees, you do not have to offer health insurance. You can, there's some incentives to try to get you to, but if you decide, I can't handle this, it's too much of an administrative burden, there is no penalty if you say, I'm not going to offer health insurance this time.
The story changes for companies that employ more than 50 full-time jobs. Those employers must provide insurance policies for employees or otherwise get penalized.
That penalty has been delayed a year to give those larger employers a chance to figure out all these new rules, to get comfortable, figure out what they're going to do as an individual business, and move forward starting in 2015.
Business owners like Vogue feel the pressure of insurance costs will cause some businesses to take a step back and cut staff so they're no longer included in the mandate.
As you know, insurance hasn't gone down in the last 10 or 15 years.
He sees the cost only going up from here. Brooke Hash, KHQA News, Hannibal.